This video is going to be all about linear transformation scene and vector scene, doing some stuff in linear algebra. The first example here, we are going into vector scene. So what I want you to notice is that we are calling a plane by self.addPlane. We're doing a similar thing with the vector and the basis vector. Now within vector scene, there are some templated animations such as self.vector to chords and self.write vector coordinates, which you'll see in the animation. What you'll notice is different here is that within the code, we've got self dot, and then we're getting vectors and getting planes and all of that stuff. That's because this self dot implies that we are grabbing the object templated within the vector scene. Going into probably my favorite sorts of animations within Manim is the linear transformation scene. Now we need to initialize our scene, and we do it with this code here. Now notice we are in the linear transformation scene. That is the template that we are going to be inheriting from. We need to initialize this scene. And to be honest, why do we write this out? I don't really know. I just asked some people in the Discord and they said that it works. So I'm happy with that. And I can see I want to show the coordinates, I want to show the ghost vectors, and I want to show the basis vectors. Now there are some other stuff you can look into the source code. If you want to add it, go for it. Now we're going to construct our animation here. We've got a matrix. That's the matrix that I'm going to apply. I've added some latex, which really just indicates to text exactly what matrix I'm going to be applying. Now again, with this self, I'm inheriting a unit square. So I've got self.unit square, which just means that that is something that is templated within the linear transformation scene. I'm going to be adding an updater with this always redraw with my text here. I want to have the determinant of A, and I want this to always be updating. So always redraw it such that it is in the center of the unit square. Again, with this stuff, I'm going to add a vector. So I'm going to go self.add vector, and I've got my numerical vector there. I've got a rectangle I'm just going to add to the scene, and I've got a circle I'm going to add to the scene, just so I can see exactly what a matrix does to things that are not vectors, okay? Maybe objects that lie on the plane. Now, this is really key to understand. If you want to add objects to the scene that you want to move with the matrix, you make sure you add them as transformable objects. And if there's anything that when you apply the matrix and you don't want it to move on the screen, you add that as a background object. Whoop. Okay. Once you've added that stuff to the scene, you can then apply your matrix, which is whatever the name of the matrix that you want to apply. And that's where all the magic's happening. Just make sure that you are adding objects that you want to transform and adding objects that you don't want to transform. And you're always going to be inheriting from this linear transformation scene, so it's worth looking at the source code to understand it. Now, just to indicate what I did in the very first video when I was applying out the animations and moving them to the center of the YouTube thumbnail, if you want to have some sort of an animation play out like that for your video, I thought it's just worth showing you now. So this is the exact code that I actually used for that little mini, you know, adding two vectors in the introduction video. I'm inheriting it from scene, so I'm not using vector scene or linear transformation scene. So I've just got a number plane that I'm going to put onto my Manim screen. Then I've got a vector, and I'm naming the vector. Now the vector, I'm just using a line, and I've got the start, so plane, towards the point, and this plane dot towards the point means that it's going to be drawn on this plane here that I've defined. And so it starts, you know, there, and ends there. And I'm going to add a tip, which makes it look like a vector, right? Because a line with an arrow at the end looks like a vector. And I'm going to do that for another vector, and another vector. And I'm going to add all of this stuff to a vector group because I want to move everything. So I'm going to call it stuff, and that's going to be my vector group. And just as a kind of like a mock YouTube logo, I've just got a rounded box that I've moved to the down left hand side of the screen with that there. And I've got the height and the width of my rectangle. Now, I'm gonna play out the animation. I'm going to draw my plane, and there is a grow from point animation style where you can pick your mobject, and then pick the point where you want that to grow out from. So I've got from the point vector1.getStart. So I want to create, because I just think that vectors look nice when you grow them from the start of the point. Again, we can do that for vector2. And now illustrating again on the nice part of Manim, they've got this transform function here. And so I'm going to transform vector2 to vector3 to give it that effect that it's moving from the origin up to the end of my vector that I've got. And then I've got a little lag start here to play out some of the other animations. Then at the end, this is where you get it to move into the center of something. Okay, you've got to have everything defined as a vector group. That way you can just call stuff, which is the vector group of everything, dot animate dot move to, and then whatever the mobject is, get center. So I want it to go to the box and the center of the box, set a width. In this case, I've got 1.2, probably because my width of the box is 1.5, so I want it to stay within the box, and give it a runtime, and you will have a nice animation play out.